Hello, and welcome to WingCast, a podcast about all things Goldwing. I'm your host, Rick Arnoldo, president of WingStuff.com and lifelong rider of the Honda Goldwing. In this podcast, we talk about the latest Goldwing news, speak with fellow riders and experts in the motorcycle industry, and discuss whatever else comes to mind. We'd love to have you join us. Well, welcome everybody to another episode of WingCast. And we decided to do something a little different this time. Recently, many of you have probably heard that the Goldwing Road Riders Association had closed. And that was a big surprise to many because they've been around for a lot of years and we have a lot of history with them. And we appreciate everything they did in the Goldwing marketplace and lifestyle and everything they did with their rallies and wingding and all that kind of stuff. And anyway, what emerged from that were two new clubs, and we decided to bring those two new clubs to you and introduce them to you. And they could tell you a little bit about their clubs and what they do. And our guest today is somebody I've known for a lot of years, and that's Anita Alkire. Anita, welcome to WingCast, by the way.
Thank you, Rick.
Yeah. And so Anita is the CEO and founder of Eagle Wings Motorcycle Association. And that is the new club that they created as a result of the closure of the Goldwing Road Riders Association, which Anita was involved with, and she'll go into that. And then there's another organization, Wing Deriders, which John Lazzaroni started, and we're going to do a separate episode with him. So I want to introduce Anita. And by the way, the other president and founder is Bruce Beeman. Yes. And Bruce isn't going to be joining us. Anita has the stage today, and she's going to tell you all about Eagle Wings Motorcycle Association and what they do and what they're all about. So with that said, Anita, good morning and welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thank you. We're excited to be here. Thank you for this opportunity. It's great to be able to share our story. And, you know, it's a short 8 months that we've been doing this, and we are humbled by our support. But we came to this with the intent of being open to all motorcycles. So our vision was a simple, fun riding, and really a big emphasis on riding, but social organization of like-minded motorcycle enthusiasts. And the reason we chose the word enthusiast was critical. It was because there are folks out there who are of our history, and we are grateful for our history with you know, GWRRA,
sure,
but that cannot ride any longer, but still have so much to offer. But we have the younger groups that are looking for rides. And so with sharing of information, of safety tips, all of those things, we felt that that was a good blend of getting everybody together at once and having the areas for each one. So we've tried to create events that will mirror that as well and hit with those key factors. So when we looked at, and we are at 4,700 members now over that in our 8 months, which we are so incredibly humble, Bruce and I are.
That was fast.
It was. It really was, and still growing quickly, and we are so appreciative for that. We have 30 districts. We have 163 chapters already, and we are in the U.S., Canada, Italy, Switzerland, and France at this point. So I get goosebumps. It's just so exciting.
So even if you're not in the United States, of course, this club has spread to other countries around the world. So
yes.
That's great.
It is. It's been, I mean, it's just, you know, like I say, it's goosebumps. It's just so exciting. But we wanted to focus in on the rider. And that was something that that I had started to do some things with. And I'm glad now to have this opportunity to really focus in on let's get out, let's go for a ride. And so that's really what we ask our chapters to do is, we're not as concerned about a meeting. We're much more concerned about get together for breakfast and go for a ride. So we've taken a lot of the formalities out, and yet we still want folks to get together. And how we include that social is get together, go for that ride, and then those who can't ride or couldn't ride today, meet them at the end someplace for whether it's a meal or ice cream or whatever it is. And that gives us the opportunity for the social time. But we want to focus on that riding. So one of the things that we're going to be putting together, and we have it being worked on at all levels now, is we want to have an interactive, if you will, mapping where the member will be able to put up their favorite ride and why. And if it's an overnighter, where they stayed and why they stayed there, what are their favorite restaurants along the way, what are the points that they want to see. And so we're going to actually piggyback that into our rally for this year. And that's going to be with a scavenger hunt, as well as people posting their rides and how they got to, in our case, Knoxville, Tennessee.
So you do have a rally this year already.
We do. We took our time finding the right location. Mm-hmm. For many GWP folks, it's a familiar location, but it'll be a very different rally. And we're staying with the word rally on purpose. It's called the Eagle Wings Rendezvous, but it's got a rally mentality to it, more so than what we're familiar with in the past, for those of us that have been with GW for so long.
I have a question. Where do people get information, all this information? Obviously, you know, there's a website or social media. Where, because, you know, as people are listening to you, I'm sure they have questions. They want to know more about you. Where do they go to get information about your club?
So probably the easiest place to send someone is to our website, which is www.EWMA-world.org. And that will have the information about Knoxville. All of that is still in the coming stages, so it should be up by the 15th, although the logo has been established now. We had a contest for that. We got a lot of folks involved. We actually had a contest for the naming of the event as well.
I saw you've been doing that. I think that's pretty cool. We used to do stuff like that too when we made big decisions. And you are asking people what they thought about logo ideas and things like that. So I think that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So your website's in the works. It's not online yet, but
it is online. It's online. We just don't have a lot of the Knoxville information up yet. So you can find out more about us. You can find about chapters close to you. Sure. You can see our list of officers from the international team to the region directors. So that's already online. So there is a lot of information now.
I think a lot of customers, as they're listening to this, especially if they're in other countries, maybe they were involved with GWRRA in the past. They want to know, do you have, you know, chapters in their country? So, you know, where would people get information on what countries do have membership available and stuff? Is that on your website?
It is on our website. Okay. But we would direct people, particularly those in Europe, to contact specifically our director overseas, sure, which is Alessandro Boveri and his wife, Maria Rosa. Okay. And they will be able to give them more information as to what they have up and coming.
If you were to highlight just from your mind what countries that you actually are in right now, what countries are you in right now besides the United States and Canada?
Yeah, in Europe, we are in Italy, and that's where he is located. We have a chapter that's going, strong chapter there. I know we have a gentleman working on a chapter in Switzerland, but I don't think we've got it finalized yet. And then a new gentleman just came on in France and wants to open the chapter in France. So it's easy for us to open chapters. All it takes is one person, because with the right enthusiastic person, they'll bring the people with them.
Well, see, this is why I mentioned this, because a lot of people listening to this, you know, if you're in a country and you have a lot of friends that have gold wings, maybe you want to start a chapter in your own country, contact Anita or contact Bruce through their website.
Yes.
And possibly you could start one in your own country. So this is actually good, not only to do the podcast to tell people about yourself, but maybe there's people out there that want to start a chapter in their own country, right? So, you know, feel free to contact Anita or Bruce on that. And we're going to have all your information on our website as well on this blog, on this podcast. So
appreciate that.
We'll have a link to everything in case people didn't write down fast enough and they have to go back and listen to the video over again. Yeah. But anyway, no, that's good because people want information. And, you know, clubs in general, I think they're great because what a social magnet. You know, it just, you know, we love our motorcycles, we love riding, and how cool has it been all these years, even for me, to be involved with all these different types of clubs, not only Go Wing Road Riders, but like even some of the other clubs, you know.
Absolutely.
You know, SCMA, and you know, there's so many clubs, and it brings people together, and then before you know it, they're getting together for dinner, whether it's on the bikes or they're just going to a movie. Or I've seen it done. It's done such wonderful things to people. It's, you know, also people look forward to the weekend because, you know, they worked all week and they just want to get that bike out and take their wife or whatever and meet their friends. And what a wonderful
locally thing. And the thing is so cool about what you just said, Rick, is that's not only locally, but think of the friends that you have now worldwide. I mean, I know that if I go to Italy, I know Alessandro would not be happy if I didn't stay with him. Yes. You know, there are people, I have folks in England, same situation. If I go to Canada, it, just traveling the United States.
Yeah.
We have friends
that
have been brought together. I mean, Honda had a great long time ago motto, which is you meet the nicest people on a Honda.
Yeah.
Well, that's true on any motorcycle. You meet the nicest people, because one of the things that I've always said is when you're going down the road and there's a motorcycle approaching you, you don't look at the brand. You just say hi. Wow. By the way, I always give them the, you know, live long and prosper, because I want them to do that. Wow. But it's all motorcyclists. We have that kindred spirit. And just a funny story. My mother asked me when JR and I were dating, and she said, Anita, I just don't know when you got so excited about motorcycles. And I said, Mom, do you remember when I was a senior in high school and thought I was dating a freshman, which I wasn't? And she says, oh, that trombone player. And I said, right, Ryan. She says, yeah. She says, I never understood that. And I said, well, that's because Ryan and I went motorcycle riding after school. I rode his dad's Kawasaki 350 and he rode his dirt bike. And my mother, to probably the day she died, thought that is not true. I would have known. But, you know, there's a freedom on a motorcycle, which is really, a lot of people have asked me why Eagle Wings. And it really came down to that. There is such a freedom when you are out on the road on a motorcycle that you can't get anywhere else. And you're free as a bird. And I know many years as a co-rider, I used to sit in the back with the arms stretched out and felt like I was flying. And the most majestic bird to me on earth is the eagle. That's where that came from. And so it's just the pride that we all have as motorcyclists when we are out on the road and we care about one another. And it is such a special community. And I don't care what you ride, it is such a special community. And we are so lucky that we have that opportunity. And we all started small. I mean, very few people, their first bike was a big touring bike.
And the camaraderie. I mean, the camaraderie is unbelievable. Even myself, I get on my bike and I go for the morning, or I go for the day, and I meet people either I know or I don't know. And if I don't know them, I know them now. I mean, it's the way it is, right? You make friends instantly on bikes. Yes. It's almost like I haven't talked to that guy, but he rides a bike and he's already my friend.
Yes.
Like, we have this common thing between us that you don't have when you're driving a car. And I totally get it. And I think everybody listening to us describe this, they get it, because we all have that, right?
Yeah.
I can't help when I see another motorcycle, you know, coming against me, you know, I'll wave. It doesn't matter what they ride. It's like, you know,
It doesn't matter. We're not looking at that. We're looking at a fellow rider.
Yeah. So the club thing, I think it's wonderful because, you know, you get to meet other people you don't know, even your wife or girlfriend, or even if you're solo. Just think about inputting you into a group of people that love doing what you love to do.
Yes.
Wonderful. And I know that what you said, you're less regimented, you know, not so much pushing the meetings and all the requirements, because I know there was a lot of requirements and a lot of things that you had to do. Some people like that. Some people didn't like it. So it sounds like, you know, you're a little looser with that and you just want to bring people together and have fun. And that's what your club's all about. I think it's fantastic.
Yeah, it really is. I mean, We are family oriented, just because I think that's what you do. But we've also looked at, now we'll only we've had one event this year, and it was our first, and that was we did a cruise, and we will do that annually. And it, what it did, it was very interesting, being it was really our first time in that environment, was it gave people the chance to interact in a very different way. And they saw Bruce and I in a very different way, and they could just come up and talk to us. So that was so much fun. And it's a very social activity. Obviously, there's not the bike involved.
So do you see, that's what I was saying before. You know, you actually put a cruise together and everybody gets to. It's like social ability on steroids. I mean, you get to meet such great people, and they're all like you. They're all motorcycle people, right? You can relate. So I'm a big fan of clubs like this.
Yeah. And then with our rally this year, and then what we'll be adding next year is we're also going to do just a ride-in. So a weekend ride-in. And that's going to give us more flexibility, because a rally is a big deal. Like, you know, it's really, it's bringing all the vendors together, and with, which just the support's been fabulous. But anyway, bringing them together, bringing the folks together, bringing some fun guest speakers together. That's going to be the rally. But we also needed an event where it would give us flexibility of places to go. And so next year we will have a ride-in. We don't have the date set yet, but it'll probably be somewhere around June. Okay. And our first ride-in location is going to be to Canada. And so it's going to be everybody head to Canada and meet, and we'll have rides there and socializations and go home. It'll be brief, but it will also allow us to come west, because there's great riding in the West. But when you look at the membership population, it has a tendency to be very concentrated east. So that gives us that ability to come west and have an event, even though it's different than the rally, but have an event for those folks too. So our plan is 3 events per year, and from the international level. And then, of course, our regions have events and districts have events.
Now, in the United States, I think people would be curious, do you have a chapter in each state? Where are you at with, you know, living in USA right now?
Not quite. We have 30 states that we've got covered, or 30 districts. And that actually, we've got a couple that are multi-district. Minn Kota is north and south Dakota and Minnesota. So that's 3 states.
And this is all on your website. So if people want to see if there's a chapter they can join in their state, it'll be on your website, whether that state is available. And I just thought of this, of course, again, if somebody wants to start a chapter in a state that you don't have a chapter going right now, they can get in touch with you, and they can possibly start a chapter in a state that is not a state that you have established it yet either.
So absolutely. If they're in an area, even if there is a chapter, if they want to start one as well, I mean, that's fine too, because sometimes, you know, a person's going to attract a different set of riders to them. So, you know, there's room for all. We don't have exclusivities or anything
that. We did a podcast in the past with a very interesting guy, and he's all about safety, and he's a motorcycle trainer, and that's Jerry Palladino. You know, and he has a series and stuff. And anyway, we mentioned that he offers advanced training, motorcycle training. Mm-hmm. And so he's got locations around the United States, and we mentioned, if you guys want to start a training location either in your country or somewhere else in the United States that he's not established, contact him. And stuff like that worked really well, because people have contacted him about that.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, talking about safety, though, that's one of the things that we took seriously, but in a very different way than what had happened with the previous organization. And that is that we want safety to be very accessible. Mm-hmm. And easy. So we are doing that, and we're doing it with bringing back what used to be called parking lot practices down at the chapter level. They were fun. They were a good time with each other. We helped each other learn, as well as doing some bike games. And those were always so much fun.
So would you, I'm getting the feel for this. And I knew even before the podcast, I had a feel for what you're doing. Would you consider your club a Goldwing eccentric club that allows all bikes to join? How would you describe your club? I think people would want to know, like, who are you? Describe like what your what your club is?
Like, well, I think it's a good point. It, you know, the membership that's come to us immediately are those that came from the closed company. So that right. was a Gold Wing oriented club, although we had associate members, which we then dropped that term to allow all. That is probably the one thing that we're working on is a mindset change, because we're looking at, if you have a group of riders that you're riding, I don't care, Yamahas or Kawasaki's or whatever it happens to be, if you're interested in coming together with some like-minded motorcyclists, which means you are interested in safety, you want to make sure that you have got some good tips going on, some good support going on in how to maybe do things a little safer, then we want you coming to us and saying we're interested. But the mind shift that's going to happen is, as now many of these Gold Wingers have come to Eagle Wings, they're having to understand we are not exclusively Gold Wing, nor will we be. And they need to understand. And it may be our dominant bike for many years to come.
I was going to say that. I think the dominant factor in your club is Gold Wings. Sure. And there's nothing wrong with that.
No.
Everybody else is welcome kind of thing. But I think the main focus comes from Gold Wing, because that's the heart of where you started. And it so I, that's kind of how I describe it anyway. I don't want to describe it for you, but that's how I read it. It's like
it's where we started. It's our foundation, right. Okay. But our foundation has to be more open. And sure. And a lot of that comes from, you know, the Goldwing community, the new bike that came out in 2018 has certainly helped bring some of the younger riders to riding. But a lot of those folks don't think they have the time to become part of an organization. And I will challenge that thinking. In the way we have structured ourselves, you do have the time, because what you really want to do is get together and go for a ride. And that's what we're going to focus on.
Yeah.
But equally, we've got to look at, there are those riders who today are not on a Gold Wing, they're on a whatever, because that fits them. And I can remember I was quite intimidated at first, because I couldn't get my feet on the ground with a Gold Wing.
You know what? I think the good part of this, as I'm listening to us go through this, is, you know, we know how to do rallies. I mean, you know, the Gold Wing, the whole Gold Wing lifestyle and stuff, you guys are good at touring, you're good at organizing rides, you're good at rallies, you're good at all those things. This is going to benefit the people that are not riding Gold Wings, because you guys have been doing this for so many years, you know how to do it. So
it's a good point. Yeah, so it's a very good point.
Yeah, so you're getting all those skills and all that experience, and you're offering it to anybody to join. I think it's wonderful, because
yes,
never be ashamed that it came from a Gold Wing.
Oh no,
because I think it's wonderful, because
we were gifted with a
goers know how to tour. They know how to do rallies. They know how to do a lot of things. So you're actually bringing that experience to the table and Absolutely. Letting everybody else in. So I think, you know, I like the whole concept of it. Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah. And that really is it. We want to start to expand. There are folks that are in a younger age bracket that, and we have some of them, that's wonderful to listen to them, although I don't get all the terminology and I don't claim to. So on Instagram and all of those things. So we have to have somebody that can speak the language correctly. But, you know, they get so excited about the things that we are doing, and particularly the fact that our safety, the way we've done our safety, is we have as small as a 10-minute subject that can just be a discussion. We want it so that all of our courses, which we don't have a lot, we've chosen some very specific subjects, but they're easy and can be taught by anyone because they are discussions.
Are you teaching any of that? Like, I know they used to have first aid classes and things like that. Are you doing any of that stuff or no?
We are. We've got first aid CPR. That is the one thing that we made the decision to keep and continue with. Because it's life-saving, and
everybody should know that. That's why I'm
thumbs. Everybody should know that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And if you took no other example of that is, you know, what happened to on the football field. You know, that gentleman, that young man was saved by people knowing that. You will save someone who is probably a family member or a very close friend someday.
Yeah, I agree. No, I'm skills.
That was critical for us. But we don't have the structure that came with the previous company. We didn't want that. I go back to when we first joined, and that was in 99, when we would have when we would meet after a meeting at the chapter. If it was a day, it was raining, so we didn't go for a ride. We would meet at somebody's house and we would talk about a safety subject. That's the way we are trying to share safety, is have a safety subject day and let's talk about what it means and what it does. And we've got some outlines that people can follow. That's where we were at, getting into, you know, life skills and
make it a little more personal, a little more casual. You know, yeah. I've been friends with a lot of people that were in that organization for mm-hmm. years. And some of them didn't like all the regimented stuff and all the rules and all, like, you know, it was a big turnoff. And then, you know, some people did like it. And so, you know, I think being a little loose and more casual is what people want nowadays.
Yeah, I think so. And it gives us the flexibility. And that's the other side of it, Rick, is it gives us the flexibility to, when you have a rider that's working full time and is trying to take a little bit of time to get out on that weekend ride or weekday ride, whatever it happens to be, we want to be able to give them that flexibility, but also be able to share those things with them in short periods of time, because that's their time frame. Yeah. So we want to honor that fact that they don't have a lot of time, that yet we want to be a fit for them too. So we're hoping that with that message, we're going to be able to get to those folks, have them come and see what's going on. Sure. But it is the year of the mindset change. So there's no doubt about that, because we came from our history. So
I mean, it sounds like fun. I mean, people want to ride. They want to meet other people and that ride bikes too. And I think that this is a good environment that brings people together mm-hmm. and a social arena, if you want to say, or vehicle where people can meet other people that are like-minded, you know, that love riding motorcycles. And no matter what you ride, you're welcome. And I think that's great. I do think it's also great that it's centered from the gold wing type of rider, and now it's funneled into everything else, which actually helps. Like I said, you know, who knows better than, you know, people involved with all those events over the years and the guys that rode, you know, that were in the chapters and stuff. So I think it's going to benefit the way you're running this. So, but you know, it's been a pleasure to have you on. I'll try to wrap it up a little bit. I think people are going to continue to want more information on this, and that's why I say your website is where they got to keep going to get updates, right?
Facebook as well. We've got a Facebook page. Eagle Wings Association is a Facebook page. It's very active. So
you're on Facebook. You have a website.
We do. Yeah. We have, I won't say our Instagram page yet is at real active, because it's not, but you can get, from the Facebook page, which a lot of folks have followed, that you can get a lot of information from, website as well. And of course it is a website format and, you know, and then watch for the information coming out for our Knoxville event, because that's Labor Day weekend. So it's August 31st through September 2nd. So, and we're going to have it's going to be a party.
And well, we're going to keep our eyes on you and follow what you guys are doing. And I think it's great. I know you enjoy doing it, and I know people appreciate it. So, you know, even though the previous organization went away, you know, we have two new organizations. So I appreciate you joining us this morning.
Thank
on our show. And of course we'll interview the other club too, and share their information too, and people can decide, do they want to join one or both,
right?
You know, and like we talked about before, there's still some states that don't have a chapter, you know, established yet. And if any of you folks are interested in starting a chapter in your state and you go to their website and see that your state is not included, reach out and contact Anita. I'm sure she would appreciate that, you know?
Yeah, we'd love it.
So, and it's all about having fun. I mean, I love riding motorcycles since I was a little kid. Mm-hmm. I couldn't imagine living without motorcycles. I mean, it's been a big part of my life, you know?
Yeah.
And I know for you too. So, you know, you've been riding bikes for a lot of years, Anita, and you know, this is your passion. And I'm glad you're still doing what you love, you know?
Yeah, we truly do. And it's, you know, we are blessed to be able to do it and to share the passion of a motorcyclist. There's just nothing like it. I don't think, even in my professional career, I just don't think there's anything quite like the passion that folks have for motorcycle. And we just want to come share it with them and have them part of the family.
Well, there you go, folks. So there's the new organization, Eagle Wings Motorcycle Association, and we'll have all the links to their website and their Facebook. It'll all be in the description for this podcast, and we want to thank everybody for joining us today, and I think they appreciate all this information, and it's exciting to see new clubs emerge as a result of something that's been around a long time going away, so there's always change, and it's very exciting, and it sounds like you get some good stuff ahead. So thanks for joining us this morning, Anita, and we'll certainly keep in touch. And if any updates or anything else happens in the future, we'll invite you back on the show again, for sure.
Would love it. Thanks, Rick. Okay.
All right. Well, thanks for joining us. And everybody else, thanks for joining us on this episode of WingCast. And always remember, ride safe, and we'll see you next time. Well, I think it's about that time that we check in with Uncle Frank and see what's going on with him right now. So I'm going to just give him a call and see what he's up to.
It's our way of keeping.
Hello. Hey. Yeah, ABC. ABC. Good morning.
Good morning. We're eating now.
You're eating. Perfect timing, because we're doing a WingCast episode, and everybody wants to check in with you, see how you're doing. You're on the radio, Uncle Frank.
Yeah, all right. I'm on the radio. What do you want me to do? Say hi. How you doing, guys?
I'm so excited. Okay, everybody. Uncle Frank is very excited that you're listening to him today. Go ahead, Uncle Frank. So what are you going to have for lunch? What are you going to eat?
We're just having eggs with cheese and stuff. That's all.
Okay. All right.
The guys okay today? The guys are okay? Where are they from?
They're from all over the world, Uncle Frank. They just like checking in with you because you're the big boss, you know?
Oh, yeah. I'm a big boss.
Yeah.
All right. I got to eat, Rick.
All right. Well, you know what? I was going to talk to you about something important, but I'm going to let you
Well, go
first,
ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. I can spare a few minutes. Go ahead.
Right. Remember, I told you I was thinking about buying a monkey, a pet monkey, a small monkey.
Oh, is that right? Now you're going to buy one.
I'm thinking about it. What do you think about that? You think it's a good idea?
I think you're crazy. I think you're crazy, Rick.
You think I'm crazy?
You're crazy buying a monkey. What are you going to do with a monkey?
I train it, interact with it, have fun saying, you know, hey, I got a pet monkey.
Don't take it here. I don't want no monkey here.
Well, I'm not going to take it on a plane and go and visit you, but all right. So you don't think it's a good idea? Is that what you're trying to
say? He's going to get a monkey jaw. What the f*** your brains, Rick, went? Where they went? I don't know where your brains went.
All right, well, we're going to talk about the monkey later. Uncle Frank, I'm kidding with you. I'm just kidding with you. I knew you were going to say something like
I'm going to eat. I'm going to eat, Rick. Go.
All right. Hey, Uncle Frank, before you go, you got to get everybody one of your
Hey!
All right. There's Uncle Frank. All right. We're going to let you eat, and I'll call you later. Remember,
all right. Bye.
Okay? He hung up on me. Oh, Uncle Frank. Perfect style. All right, everybody. See you on the next episode.
Thanks for listening to WingCast. This has been a WingStuff.com production. Please be sure to rate, review, and subscribe to us wherever you listen to podcasts. Got a question or comment for me? Send an email to wingcast@wingstuff.com, and it could be featured on a future episode. You can also visit wingstuff.com and sign up for our newsletter to stay up to date on the newest podcast episodes, products, videos, Goldwing news, sales, and more. Until next time, I'm Rick Arnoldo. Ride safe.